This thing is, without any question, the coolest looking electric pickup I have ever seen. Blows my mind. Hello, my friends. Welcome to the Electric Viking. My name is Sam Evans. Great to have you here on the channel. Welcome to all the new subscribers. Welcome back to everyone else. I'm coming to you here from Melbourne, Australia. It is 5:30 a.m. It's a beautiful morning. I've got some great news for you here. I don't know why, but this excites me. I love seeing really different, radical-looking electric cars. When I saw this model of car, I saw an article for this a couple of months ago, and this company was saying, "Hey, check out our updated version of this pickup truck." And I looked down, I scrolled down, I saw it was gas-powered, and I was like, whatever, I don't care. Who cares? It's another boring gas-powered truck. Looks cool though, looks cool. If only it was electric. If only it was electric. And guess what? The company has just said, "Yeah, you're right, Viking. Let's electrify this baby. Let's make this thing the coolest looking pickup truck on the face of the planet. And let's give it 1,300 horsepower while we're at it, or 900 plus kilowatt." Chinese company Dongfeng will launch a high-end electric off-road brand. The brand is codenamed M. They're just the letter M. They are planning three cars: the M18-1, the M18-2, and the M18-3. Very imaginative branding here, isn't it? Anyway, the first car, the M18-1, is nicknamed the pure electric version of the Warrior. The Warrior is actually a pickup truck that's been used by the Chinese government as like a military vehicle for many, many years. Apparently, they are extremely good off-road. So this new electric pickup truck will be based on a new MORV electric off-road vehicle platform developed by Dongfeng, which is a Chinese state-owned company. Production is set to start in 2023. And it's kind of like a rival for GM's GMC Hummer electric pickup truck. It kind of looks the same, extremely wide, but it's actually a lot lighter. So the M18 will be equipped with a level 2.5 driving assistance system, an 800 kilowatt or 1100 horsepower motor that can accelerate from 0 to 100 or 0 to 62 miles an hour in less than 5 seconds, has a cruising range of 500 kilometers, and it has a 140 kilowatt hour battery pack with a fast charging time of only 27 minutes. I'm going to guess it's got to have at least 250 kilowatt charging rate, which is pretty damn good. The power consumption per 100 kilometers is 26 kilowatt hour, which is pretty good for a vehicle of this size, this shape. I mean, it looks like a brick. There's no aerodynamics considered to this vehicle whatsoever. That's probably why I love it too. Now, for comparison's sake, the GMC Hummer EV produces up to 745 kilowatt in its Edition 1 guise, which apparently General Motors have delivered. Started delivering those vehicles last year. But so far, they, as far as I know, have delivered one. So, yeah, there's that. However, the Hummer has a sub-4-second 0 to 100 time and uses a 200 kilowatt-hour battery pack. Probably why it weighs more than a ton more than this baby. So the Warrior is around 5.2 meters long. So is the M18-1. Which is about the same length as a Nissan Patrol. So it's not really all that long. It's quite wide, but not all that long. Incredibly, in a change for pickup trucks. I mean, a lot of pickup trucks can weigh a lot, but this thing only weighs 3.1 ton, and that's 380 kilos less than its petrol variant. So it's 400 kilos lighter than the gas-powered version, and 1 ton lighter than the GMC Hummer EV edition, but it's also obviously quite a bit smaller. So the question here is, what is the price? So the price will be between 600,000 and 700,000 RMB. Yep, it's expensive. $94,000 to $110,000. Production's gonna take place at a new 485 acre facility, massive, where Dongfeng broke ground in January this year, and which the company says will have an annual capacity of 100,000 electric pickups. That's pretty cool. Now, for those of you who don't know, in China, the SUV craze and the pickup truck craze is really starting to take hold, with Dongfeng the latest automaker to introduce a rugged SUV brand after Great Wall Motors. Great Wall Motors' SUV brand is called Tank. Chery's Jetour brand too is planning a line of rugged SUVs under the T-Series nameplate. State-owned Dongfeng is considered one of the Chinese big four automakers, with Chang'an, FAW Group, and SAIC Motor, who is the parent company of MG and LDV, among other brands. Dongfeng also has a joint venture with Nissan in China, where it builds Nissan's vehicles, Honda's vehicles as well, which is called Dongfeng Honda. And Stellantis, where it builds Peugeot and Citroen cars for Stellantis. As I've mentioned before on the channel, with Korean car sales decreasing in China, Dongfeng sold its stake in the joint venture Dongfeng Yuda Kia in late 2021. Another joint venture, Dongfeng Renault, was dissolved the previous year. Outside of those joint ventures, Dongfeng introduced a premium new energy vehicle brand in 2021 with the name Voyah. And Voyah is actually the highest selling luxury EV in China. Outsells the Porsche Taycan. And it's actually around about the same price as the Taycan. But interestingly, customers see it as more premium. It's an incredibly cool vehicle. I'll put a link in the description below to the video I made about the Voyah. Interestingly, it's been outselling every luxury car in China in the super premium segment almost every month for the last six straight months. The Free, it's a large crossover and it comes with either plug-in hybrid or all electric powertrains. It's got a lot of power as well. Now they also make a vehicle called the Dreamer. It's an upscale electric people mover. If you're looking for a high-end or a bigger electric SUV, NIO has one that they're going to be selling in a bunch of different markets soon. In addition to that, BYD also will be bringing out a vehicle called the Tang, which is a mid to large size electric SUV that you may be able to buy. It's coming to Australia at some point in time. I believe it's coming to a bunch of different European countries. I'm not sure where else, but it is going to be a global car on BYD's menu. If you haven't been watching this channel for a while, you wouldn't be aware of the fact that there are so many new Chinese electric cars coming out almost every week that are mostly very, very affordable. Some of them are in the mid-price range, but they're incredibly good for what they are. So make sure you check out the channel more often because I'm going to be showing you cars that are probably going to be available in your country soon. Why'd I say that? Well, if you have a look at the sales figures for Chinese automakers over the last 12 months, they've gained massive market share, not just in China, but in a number of other countries, including Australia. Here in Australia, Chinese automakers have increased their market share by more than 150% in the past 12 months. I think you're going to see a similar timeline for Chinese auto companies in much of the world once they start to move to wherever you are. And I'll let you know when those car companies are coming to your country. Let me know, what do you think of this electric pickup truck? Am I getting overexcited? Would you like to own one too? This to me is like a toy fantasy, like something you'd think, yeah, that would be freaking awesome. And you think that when you're seven and then you grow up and you discover you're 40 years old and you still think the same thing. I don't know why it is, but it just looks like a lot of fun to me. Let me know in the comment section below if you'd own one of these or if you think they're cool or fun as well. Let me know what you think. Have a great day. I'll see you again on the next video. Bye-bye.